I have any units that I'm not using at the moment? Aha. Who are these? Oh, alright. They're hidden. Where are they, actually? Ah, there they are. They're in the woods. Let's see here. I will have them also charge in. Actually, no. I'll have them charge against these Royal House Skulls here while these guys attack them from behind. Okay. Let's see how this works. Alright, so they turned around, so I wasn't able to hit them in the flank. But I still will be able to hit them from behind. Oh, no, I will be able to hit them in the flank. Excellent. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Okay. Oh dear. This ambush did not go the way I was hoping. At all. Okay. Now this is relatively under control, so let's check out what's going on over here. Pretty close battle. How did these guys do? Pretty well, actually. Okay, so I have some extra cavalry hanging out. So let's strike these house scarls from behind. Actually, you know what? Let's strike these light feared from behind first. I have all these archers up here. Just rain some death down on these guys. All right. I'm not going to say anything, so I don't want to jinx it, but things are going okay. Let's just take a look at these House Scarls. They're tough, tough English troops, that's for sure. Very tough. Got a few javelins in the back, and a few charges. Always help. Plus the morale support of my general. Okay, so I have some bowmen giving me a hard time, so I'm going to bring these cavalry up to get rid of them. Now this charge seemed to have worked quite nicely. Now where do those House Scarls go? Oh, there they are, and there's only 12 of them left. That's excellent. Alright, I just have a few men that were routing. I'll just have them kind of guard these guys. Excellent. Alright, so it's time to, let's see here, these men, I'll have this cavalry chase away this. Oh my goodness, look at all that dead. Oh my god, what a slaughter this is. And while I bring these guys up to assist in this final larger battle right here. Let's see. Okay, yeah, all those arrows hitting those House Scarls, they're not going anywhere. So let's get rid of my cavalry so they don't get killed anymore. Try to take care of these archers. Oh, no, they've fled. Cowards. Cowards, cowards, cowards. Alright. Oh, it still looks like they can win. Oh! Excellent. Looks like the enemy commander has fallen. That is great news for me. Alright, let's clean up these archers. Okay, and now let's bring my extra infantry this way. Oh, extra House Scarls. Oh dear. Okay, I'm gonna have to try to hold them off as best I can. Okay, I'm gonna have to switch these guys to fire arrows because these guys need to break. And pronto. Okay, I'm gonna have to use my general here to do a flanking maneuver Perhaps I could distract these house garls. Or maybe not. There they go. Excellent. They've broken. Oh, that's fantastic. Alright, so I'll stop these guys from firing at will. Bring these guys to clean up these house garls, and bring these guys to assist in this final fight here. Then withdraw my general, because arrows are flying in the backs. Sorry I haven't been able to show very many close-ups, but with all, I was ambushed, so it makes it a little bit on the difficult side. Alright. Okay, we're gonna stop with this. My archers here. Well, they're almost out of ammunition, so never mind. We'll have the crossbows still do their thing. Excellent. Actually, if the crossbows are doing their thing, I should probably get out of, you know, the line of fire. So, now I have them nearly surrounded. Nearly. And you know what? We gotta use my weight of numbers here. Where are my archers that are already used there? Okay, so they've already used all their ammunition. So I'm gonna have them charge in from behind here. And by then, I think the rest of my ammo should be used up, with the exception of these... Oh. Where are they? There we are. Victory. Wow, that was a lot closer than I kind of wanted. I'm going to continue the battle, just to round up as many men as possible, but I'll see you on the... I'll show you a little bit of the routing, just so you can get a better look at these models. First things first, though, I'm going to kind of get rid of the fire at will here. Excellent. And so we'll have... What's left of my cavalry help round up the remaining units of the fleeing English. Okay, so... Yeah, so here's my general's bodyguard. The models in this game are excellent. You will probably also notice that the landscaping, the trees and everything like that, are quite different. Oh, it started to rain a little bit. How applicable. Alright, so, yeah, these are some of my spearmen, right here. My archers, running for no apparent reason now. Okay, so while they're cheering, I'm going to continue to chase down some of these men. Let's see here. Let's get rid of some bowmen. Actually, let's try to get rid of this light feared. These are light infantry. Very beautiful game. Beautiful, beautiful game. It's really phenomenal. So, that was a clear victory with 2,404 kills and 1,023 losses. Let's see here. Some of my knights got some great experience. And I also got quite a few kills thanks to my cavalry, actually. And it looks like my crossbowmen also did a really good job. I had some axemen here that did a fantastic job as well. All in all, I'm just very glad that I won that battle. So, the enemy army has routed. I like this message. Feared Duke, our pitiful foes have fled. They are goats, not men. And, like goats, let them bleat of their bravery from a safe hiding place. Very good. So, now I have a decided advantage here when it comes to this battle. And before I start this major scrum, maybe I'll spring an ambush of my own. How about we will put one of them right here? No, can I hide? Will you let me hide? I don't know if they're hiding or not. I don't know if they're hiding at all. Well, tell you what. Instead, what I'll do is I'll take my remaining forces here, and we're going to besiege this English town. Actually, I'm going to maintain the siege there for a second. I'm going to bring this army up to assist. And, you know what? This town doesn't have any walls. Let's take it. Excellent. Alright, so all they have are 41 peasants. So I'll get back to you in a sec. My goodness, isn't this a gorgeous looking mod? I think so. Everything's just rich and dark and very, very English, actually. Let's just destroy these peasants as easily as possible. So that will be by bringing up my archers and shooting them to death. So I'll get back to you when I do that. So my crossbows are getting ready to fire, and in the meantime I'll just bring my cavalry up to the side, so if these peasants decide to come out, I'll just destroy them then. But here they go in a flood of arrows. I've already almost taken out half their number in one volley, and in the second volley, they're even less. So they'll break and surrender within a moment, and all will be won. Oh yes, they don't even have a chance. They have one. Looks like he was House Scarl in charge of the city, and now he is dead. And that was a nice, easy victory. We'll end the battle. Not a single loss, which shouldn't be any surprise. So, I have the possibility of occupying the settlement, enslaving it, or laying it to waste. The Normans were notorious for just laying everything to waste, so I'm going to do that. Of course, that doesn't really help the population. Well, this is really interesting. Here, I'll go through these in a second, actually. I just want to look at what's causing this. New law is completely screwing everything up. Let's see here. Local lordship. Ah, I see. So if I offer a local lordship, they'll actually calm down. If I offer feudal lordship, it just brings a little bit of law, but I'm still not able to control them properly. So I'm going to... Actually, let's look at the description here for a second. This enforces Norman yoke upon the populace, and this allows... let's see here. It's a more peaceful transition to Norman rule. Okay. Let's do the peaceful transition. And with that, Robert de Montaigne has taken and laid to waste the first city. So, before I start in this main battle, I thought I'd show you a few more features of this mod. As you can see, there's a brand new building browser, and it's quite detailed with some very historic historic buildings and building types. Also, this is one thing I really, really am flabbergasted and impressed with. First of all, they have player information, you know, the victory conditions, which is fine, but for each region, there's a provincial information, and it gives you the population, what earldom it is, what titles you can get from it, the geography of it, and the actual history of the area. It is just so detailed, and so much attention and care has been brought into this mod. It is a real treat to play. Here I am just gushing about it. But you can build anything from, let's see here, let's just see the building browser. Barracks, of course, cavalry, siege ranges, master blacksmith, a royal mint. Oh my goodness, that's cool. We have ourselves boat builders and docks, farms, of course, a mill, a water mill, Christian churches, and monasteries, inns, and taverns, and of course, like I showed before, either local or feudal lordship.